गुड मॉर्निंग एचओडी प्रोफेसर एके चतुर्वेदी सर, माय सेमिनार गाइड मनीष चतुर्वेदी सर, सेमिनार कोऑर्डिनेटर डीपी शर्मा सर, फैकल्टी मेंबर्स, एग्जामिनर्स एंड माय फ्रेंड्स, आई एम प्रियंकाला दीक्षित परसुइंग माय बीटेक इन मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग फ्रॉम यूनिवर्सिटी डिपार्टमेंट राजस्थान टेक्निकल यूनिवर्सिटी कोटा। माय सेमिनार टॉपिक इज सीआई फॉर कूलिंग इन बैटरी मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम ऑफ ई व्हीकल। दिस इज गोइंग टू बी आवर ओवरव्यू। फर्स्टली द क्वेश्चन अराइजेस दैट why cooling in battery management system is essential or why it is needed. So the electric vehicles obviously don't have that engine issue, but their batteries need to be cooled to help preserve their performance and lifespan. By using a cooling system, the battery management system can regulate the temperature of the battery and ensure that it operates within a safe range. This can help to extend the lifespan of the battery and improve the overall performance of the electric vehicle. Therefore, cooling is essential in BMS to ensure the safety, reliability and longevity of the battery. Now, about the introduction of electric vehicle or EVs. Conventional vehicles use fossil fuels, and pollution due to combustion is a serious concern on the environment. The scope of electric vehicles EV has been essential due to the adverse impact of fossil fuels on the environment. An electric vehicle does not use any fossil fuel for power generation and has zero emission. An electric vehicle is a vehicle that runs on electric motors powered by rechargeable batteries, packs, instead or internal combustion engine fueled by gasoline or diesel. Electric vehicles have several advantages like improved energy efficiency, performance, environmentally friendly and are free from the combustion generated pollution. Now moving on to the units of electric vehicle. Electric engine or motor, it is a prime mover and provides power to rotate the wheels. The electric motor can be DC or AC type. However, for electric vehicles, AC motors are widely used. Inverter, it converts the electric current from DC into AC. Drivetrain, EVs use a single speed transmission which transfers electric power from the motor to the wheels of the vehicles. Batteries or power banks. Batteries modules store electricity required to drive an electric vehicle. The power capacity of the battery is measured in kilowatt. Charging point. Electric vehicle charging point in the form of the plug to charge the battery modules. Now the most essential system, that is battery management system of e-vehicle. A battery management system is a critical component in electric vehicle that helps to manage the energy storage system. It monitors the battery state of charge, voltage, temperature and other parameters to ensure the safety, reliability and optimal performance of the battery. BMS in an electric vehicle is responsible for managing the battery pack performance and ensuring its safety. One critical aspect of BMS is thermal management, which involves regulating the temperature of battery pack. Computer-aided engineering is used extensively in the automotive industry to assist in the design and development of vehicle battery management system. The BMS also controls the charging and discharging of battery to ensure that it is charged safely and efficiently, and to prevent overcharging or over-discharging, which can damage the battery. The cooling principle in BMS for EVs is to prevent the battery from overheating, which can cause degradation of the battery's performance and lifespan. So battery cooling system in electric vehicle is essential for better functioning and performance of the vehicle. The challenges of BTMS. The following are the major challenges faced in the development of battery. Long charging time. The charging time for an electric vehicle can vary based on the charging station and the vehicle's battery size. Overheating of the battery is a serious issue that can lead to reduced battery life damage to the device or even fires and explosions. High cost of battery. Managing the expenses associated with charging electric vehicles can be challenging, particularly when employees are charging their electric vehicles at public charging station or at different location. Safety against heating or short circuit. Batteries can pose safety risks such as overheating, fires or explosions. Ensuring the safety of the batteries is a critical challenge in their development. The limited life of battery. The limited life of the battery is a common challenge in its usage. particularly in the portable devices and electrical vehicles. One of the topic is liquid cooling of batteries. Indirect liquid cooling. Indirect liquid cooling is a common method used to cool batteries in electric vehicles and other applications where high power densities are required. Some electric vehicles manufacturers such as General Motors and Tesla are using indirect cooling in their cars. General Motors use cold plates between their prismatic cell. Direct liquid cooling or immersion cooling. Direct liquid cooling is also called as immersion cooling, covers the entire surface of the cell and cools it uniformly. BTMS for this method is not suitable for most mass produced EV due to high cost and safety concerns. Immersion cooling removes hot or cold spots in the cell and significantly improves the performance of the cell. Immersion cooling is widely used for the data center servers and high power electronic devices. Immersion cooling also useful for the batteries of the high performing EVs and EV racing. So now about the application of BMS of electric vehicles. So there are a number of applications like grid energy storage or renewable energy system, portable electronics, medical devices, aerospace and defense sector, and marine and boating and mining and construction. Now about the overall conclusion of the topic. Developing a system model for battery management in electric vehicle is essential to optimize the performance, efficiency, and lifespan of the battery. The system model should consider various factors such as the battery's chemistry, temperature, current and voltage level, state of charge and discharge rate. The model should also incorporate real-time monitoring and control of the battery to prevent the overcharging, overheating and other issues that can cause damage to the battery. So that was all about my seminar topic. Thank you.